President Biden became the first U.S. leader to witness firsthand Samsung's advanced chipmaking tech. By visiting the manufacturing complex, he looks to strengthen the semiconductor alliance. Eum Ji-young tells us more.
U.S. President Joe Biden's first stop in South Korea, a trip to the world's largest semiconductor plant, boasting the world's first base for 3-nanometer class chips.
I've just seen how this plant makes the most advanced semiconductor chips in the world. They're a wonder of innovation, design, precision, and manufacturing.
Samsung Electronics Semiconductor Manufacturing Complex in Pyeongtaek, south of Seoul, spans a site 2.89 million square meters in area, about the size of 400 football fields combined. The first assembly line began full operations in 2017 and the second in 2020, mass-producing chips including DRAM and NAND flash. And Line 3, in which the tech giant has invested more than $23 billion, is scheduled to be finished in the second half of this year and will churn out next-generation chips using advanced technology. A fourth line is also planned for making system chips. President Biden's visit to the Pyeongtaek campus on Friday is seen as a move to strengthen the technology alliance between Seoul and Washington.
Our two nations work together to make the best, most advanced technology in the world. And this factory is proof of that. And that gives both the Republic of Korea and the United States a competitive edge in the global economy. If we can keep our supply chains resilient, reliable, and secure.
Samsung Electronics is also building a new cutting-edge semiconductor plant in Texas in the city of Taylor. This $17 billion foundry line will be Samsung's second in Texas, situated roughly 50 kilometers from its giant manufacturing hub in Austin. The new plant, spanning more than 5 million square meters, is planned to start operating around the end of 2024. President Biden says this will create some 3,000 high-tech jobs and thanked Samsung for also working with Stellantis to manufacture batteries for electric vehicles. President Yoon Suk-yeol says supply chain cooperation is already underway through the South Korea-U.S. semiconductor partnership.
″저는 반도체가 우리 미래를 책임질 국가 안보 자산이라고 생각하면서 과감한 인센티브와 필요한 지원을 아끼지 않을 계획입니다. 바이든 대통령께서도 우리 반도체 기업들의 미국 투자에 대한 각종 인센티브를 제공할 뿐 아니라 미국의 첨단 소재, 장비, 설계 기업들의 한국 투자에도 큰 관심을 가져주시기를 부탁드립니다.
엄지영, 아리랑 뉴스.